students. Today we are going to discuss our next unit. This unit is basically concerned about cost and variance analysis. So the title of this unit is Cost and Variance Analysis. Cost and variance analysis. Before moving further, let me explain to you guys that in case of CMA part 1, there are some certain areas of syllabus which is very important for you guys to understand in order to pass CMA part 1 exam in first attempt. This portion, this is basically the first unit of performance management to manage the performance of a company. Extremely important from exam point of view. I never seen any examination for the past 7, 8, 9 years with my experience. I never saw this thing in my experience that there is no question from cost and variance analysis. There is no question. There is no examination with this portion. So this is extremely important that we should understand this very important concepts. Okay, so the first point I will discuss in front of you, that is called basically overview. What is the overview of cost and variance analysis? What is the variance analysis? The variance means that there will be budgeted quantity and after that there will be actual quantity. So the actual minus budgeted, this is called equals to variance. So there can be two types of variance, either that can be favorable or that can also be unfavorable as well. So in detail I will discuss in front of you. In case of variance analysis, that is extremely important that you guys understand the concept of static and flexible budget. The concept of static budget and flexible budget, that is extremely important with reference to variance analysis. Now let me tell you guys that there are many different types of variances. The first type of variance which I will discuss in front of you, this is called basically direct material variance. The variance of direct material. After that I will discuss with you direct labor variance, the variance analysis with reference to direct labor, and with reference to material and labor, there will be two advanced level of variances as well. This is called mix and yield variance. Don't worry about the names, I will explain in front of you, and don't worry, I will make it easy for you guys as well. Once the material and labor variances are finished, we will discuss overhead variance. That means how to analyze the variance analysis of the overheads. So this is also extremely important. Overheads here, we understand that means variable overheads or the fixed overheads as well. And once we're done with material variances, we talk about labor variances, we talk about overhead variances. Extremely important is basically sales variances. That means in terms of number of units, how many number of units we budgeted last year, and actually how many number of units we are actually able to sell. Not only in terms of when we talk about in terms of number of units, but also in terms of dollar amount as well. So that is extremely important in order to understand the cost and variance analysis.